Our daughter Bonnie is the type of kid, she's very outgoing.
She is academic honors, and she prides herself in being an intense athlete.
My freshman year, I started getting really, really bad panic attacks and really high anxiety, and I had a lot of problems sleeping.
Different from the typical teenage type angst and anxiety, because it was the type of thing that wouldn't go away.
She did have a history of her thyroid being of concern, but it was always in a monitoring stage. And our PCP was one that thought that at some point, you know, maybe this would become a problem.
It became an acute issue a year ago. She was starting to have issues with isolated incidents where she passed out, and they weren't sure, you know, what the problem was. And then she ended up having Graves' disease.
When a patient's initially told that they have Graves' disease, it can be very nerve-wracking for the patient and the family.
A lot of times the family is not expecting that there actually is an abnormality within the thyroid gland, and so they come to us with an element of surprise, and clearly that surprise brings with it anxiety.
They're aware that their thyroid gland or their child's thyroid gland is abnormal, and so the first thing they're thinking about is this a bad disease?
Many centers which provide excellent care from pediatric endocrinology just don't have the patient population where they have all the resources that are combined in one center to afford the families a multidisciplinary approach to evaluation and treatment.
And that's why our multidisciplinary pediatric thyroid center is so important for families such as that, because from the word go, once the diagnosis is made or once the referral is made, we can sort of envelop that family and that child with all these layers of expertise in a multidisciplinary way to get the optimal care individualized for that child.